Let's take a look at this bottle cap design. On one side, the handle blends nicely into the main face of the cap, following its curvature. On the other side, it gradually transitions into a handle. There's an aesthetic rib line here that goes all around the handle. The cap body has a recess where the handle is seated. Start with the extrusion of a cylinder. In this case, we shall add a slight taper to give it a familiar bottle cap shape. Next, we are going to create a copy of the body. Click on the body in the Bodies folder. Press Ctrl+C to copy and Ctrl+V to paste. The Move Copy dialog box comes up. Just click OK to create a copy in the exact same location. The reason for making this copy will become clear as we progress further. Let's rename this body and hide it for the moment. A portion of the handle will be carved out from the body we have here. The handle has a certain profile looking from the side. Start a sketch on the right plane. First, we need to project the edges of the conical face. Using the regular project command will create unwanted entities and add unnecessary clutter to the sketch. Let's use the intersect tool instead. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select the conical face and click OK. These two lines are a result of the intersection between the current sketch plane and the conical face. Select them both and set them to construction. These two lines will serve as the outer boundaries of the sketch. At the top, we have two straight lines with an arc in the middle. At the bottom, we have an arc and a straight line. If you are following along, don't be too concerned with the dimensions. Just a rough shape will do. However, do make sure that this pair of straight lines crosses the front plane. This will make the transition into the handle later easier to control. Let's use this sketch to split the body. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the main body as a body to split, and select the sketch lines as the tools. We will no longer have any use for these two bodies. Let's Ctrl select these two bodies, right click, and remove them. This will appear as steps in the timeline. You can also choose to hide them instead of removing them. In this case, it would be better to remove them as it can be confusing to have too many bodies in the Bodies folder. Let's perform a shell on this body to remove the inside material. Select the top face. For the bottom, make sure to select the flat face also. Adjust the thickness. Looking at the final shape of the handle, you can see that only the first half of the handle follows the cap body, while the second half deviates from the cap body and forms a ring on the outside. We shall retain the first half and remove the second half. Go to Modify, Split Body. And use the front plane as a splitting tool. Just as a reminder, we have split the body across a straight segment. Remove the unwanted portion. we shall perform a sketch to draw out the path of the handle. By splitting the original body along the straight segment, we were able to ensure that this is a flat face. So we can right-click on this face to perform a sketch. We will start with two straight lines. Let's add a fillet here. Sometimes it might be hard to select the corner directly. Another way of adding the fillet is by selecting the two lines near the corner. Let's mirror this across the Z-axis. And we will join the two ends with a three-point arc. Adjust the arc until it snaps tangent to the straight lines. We will be using this sketch to make a loft. Go to Create Loft. Select these two cut faces as the profiles. With the chain selection option checked, select this sketch as the rail. Ideally, to achieve a better shape, you will want to create another rail at the bottom. In this tutorial, we will do just a one for demonstration. For operation, select Join so that this loft will merge into the rest of the handle as one body. Let's take a look at creating this recess on the cap body for seating the handle. This recess will be created on the copy of the cap body that we created earlier. Let's unhide that body. It will be a challenge to try to create this cut directly on the cap. An easier way to do this is to use a handle as a cutting tool. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the cap body as the target. For two bodies, click on the select box and select the handle. Set the operation to cut. We do need to keep the handle after the operation. So remember to check the Keep Tools option. Let's create a bit of clearance between the handle and the cap. Go to Modify, Offset Face. We can do this either on the cap or the handle. In this case, I will choose to offset faces on the cap. Let's hide the handle. Select these faces. Set the offset distance. To create this rib, we first need to create a path. This path will be offset from the top and go all around the outer surface of the handle. There is no need to do a complicated 3D sketch for this. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select the top surface of the handle and set an offset distance. We shall use this surface as a cutting tool to split the outer surface of the handle to create a path for the rib. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select the face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the surface. Sometimes, the offset surface created might not fully intersect with the outside face. So let's check the Extend Splitting Tool option. The rib line is basically a semicircular sweep that goes around the handle. Instead of making a profile sketch, let's use a pipe command which has ready-made profiles. Go to Create, Pipe. Start selecting the path. Even with the chain selection option checked, Fusion sometimes does not select the whole chain. In that case, you will need to control select the edges. choose a circular section, adjust the size, and set the operation to join. Since the circular section is centered on the path, this exposes a semicircular protrusion all the way around. Lastly, adding fillets.